The National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences, part of the National Institutes of Health, is all about getting more treatments to more patients more quickly. NCATS emphasizes collaboration, innovation, and deliverables, relying on the power of data and new technologies to develop, demonstrate, and disseminate improvements in translational science. NCATS preclinical researchers use a state-of-the-art, high-throughput robotic screening system to test hundreds of thousands of compounds that are potential drugs against disease-relevant assays. An assay is a test using cells or proteins involved in a particular disease or biological process the researchers want to study. Compounds tested in assays by the NCATS robots are analyzed in collaboration with partners from academia, nonprofit organizations, pharmaceutical and biotechnology companies, and government agencies, including other NIH institutes and centers.
The robotic system operates 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. This can help researchers make discoveries that can become a starting point in developing a new drug.
The amount of work the robots perform in a week, 3 million tests, would take a person working 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, about 12 years to complete.
The robots enable us to run about 50 different disease assays each year, many for rare disorders, but also some for health conditions that are more common, such as cancer and cardiovascular diseases.
These compounds help researchers understand biological processes on a molecular level to determine whether that process might be a good target for a drug. When compounds are used in this manner, they are called probes. NCATS biologists, together with their collaborators, design all assays carried out in this lab. A good assay will simplify a disease process into an engineered system, a gene, protein, or cell that produces a measurable change, such as light production, when a compound has an effect. Biologists first try out a new assay by conducting small-scale tests, using compounds with known activities to see if they can be detected. If successful, a larger-scale test of the assay, using a few thousand compounds, is performed. Once all of these validations are successful, the researchers move the assay to the large, fully automated robotic screening system. During each step of assay development, informatics and computational researchers, who are experts in data analysis, play a critical role in analyzing the large volume of results produced. The NCATS robotic system enables researchers to routinely test a library of 450,000 chemical compounds. Part of that library consists of the NCATS pharmaceutical collection, which includes most of the approved and investigational drugs from around the world. If one of these compounds works in the assay, it can potentially move into human trials quickly because these compounds have already been demonstrated to be safe in humans. At one station, a dispenser transfers the cell or protein assay to a plastic tray with 1,536 tiny wells. Think of each well on the plate as a test tube. Depending on the project, genes, proteins, or cells from healthy people or patients are used in the assays. The assay plates are transported to the next station of the robotic system, where the chemical compounds are added. NCATS scientists develop the next phase of the process, called quantitative high-throughput screening, during which each compound is added at several different doses, rather than at a single dose, to determine the most effective dose. The plates are incubated for a specific period to let the compounds affect the assay. Subsequently, they are transported to one of the plate readers. These are essentially highly sensitive cameras that detect whether or not those compounds altered the cell or protein in the desired way. The information from the robot plate reader is converted into numerical data, and NCATS informatics and computational researchers analyze the results from the robotic screen to identify the compounds that showed activity. The informatics researchers and biologists then work with NCATS medicinal chemists to determine the most promising compounds to work on. Though the NCATS robotic systems test hundreds of thousands of compounds, the many properties a compound must have for it to be used as a probe or drug are virtually never found in hits from a screen. Rather, hundreds or even thousands of chemical modifications of these hits must be made to identify a molecule that delivers the maximum effect at the lowest dose with the fewest side effects.
Medicinal chemistry is somewhat like cooking. It's like you follow a recipe and the first time it may not turn out the way you want it to. So you do a few modifications and you change the taste. The same way in medicinal chemistry, we change the structure of the compounds, and we keep doing that iteratively till we get that final compound with the desired profile we want, with the right biological activity, with the right properties.
This iterative process, encompassing medicinal chemistry, robotic screening, informatics, and biology, is a true team effort involving all of NCATS scientific disciplines working closely together. The resulting chemical compounds are used in further cell and animal testing to determine the role biological processes play in health and disease, and eventually in humans, to assess their potential as drugs for treating a disease. The compounds developed at NCATS open new avenues to our understanding of biology and treatment of disease. However, since much additional optimization and testing are required for a compound to be approved for treating disease in people, NCATS and its collaborators actively license their promising compounds to biotechnology and pharmaceutical companies. For example, NCATS researchers identified a compound that looks promising for the treatment of Gaucher disease, a rare inherited condition. That compound has been licensed to a biotechnology company that aims to advance the compound into clinical trials. NCATS continues its work on hundreds of similar projects aimed at getting more treatments to more patients more quickly. NCATS, improving health through smarter science.